I've used a few different methods of exterior insulation. I've used foam back in the day. We would just use polyiso on our walls. I have also used the polyiso foam attached to plywood sheathing, which is becoming very popular right now. In this case, I prefer this wood fiber over all of those products for a multitude of reasons. The foam is really gross to work with. I fully feel there's going to be class action lawsuits in the future with guys in the field having health issues. This is just recycled wood, so as you know, we cut it with a razor knife and we cut it with a circular saw. It's tongue and groove, so all we did was we snapped one reference line around the entire building, and then it was really easy for the two of us to just kind of work our way up, and then we'd fill in around the edges of all our openings and cut out all our openings. So we tacked everything on first with 2.5-inch stainless steel staples. Cost us, I think it was $200 for a box of 10,000 staples. So pretty easy to put on. We just used some metabo nailers. And then the real attachment comes when we put our furring strips on, and we use 4.5-inch screws to go through our furring strips and into our studs by about 1.75 inches that'll lock all of this in place forever. So. Is this a difficult step for any kind of home build? It's another step. It's no different than, I mean, it's a lot easier than attaching plywood sheathing to walls. I mean, this stuff is light as a feather. The two of us did this in a few days, maybe a little longer, goofing around, not working full days, you know, kind of taking our time doing it. If we had trained, say, the framing crew to do this, they would have done this entire process in one day. So all in all, it cost us about $5,000 to put this exterior wood fiber insulation on this house. And if we talk about materials and processes in terms of percentages of total project cost, which is a really good way to look at the cost of a project versus square foot cost. Everyone says like square foot is one of the worst ways to talk about what a project costs, yet it invariably falls to the default way that we talk about it. If you talk about total percentage of project cost, this exterior wood fiber insulation comes in at about 0.46% of our total project cost. And it's gonna do, it's basically gonna weatherize our entire house. Like this, I think this would be one of the most important things we put on this house. And for less than half of 1% of total project cost, I think it's worth it. I mean, we've seen this absorb 11 inches of rain in 24 hours. And then 24 hours after the rain ended, putting a moisture meter on this, it was already below what exterior wood needs to be in order to put paint on it. It was virtually bone dry 24 hours later. So, and we saw the wind blow the rain 17 feet inside the floor of the house through our open windows. And this wood fiber board was already dry. So why did we choose this product? When you learn that there's a better product out there for people, planet, profits, all of the triple bottom line, how do you then not use that? And when you look at it as total percentage of project cost, and it's less than half of 1%, how do you then say no to that? Do you say, well, let's use a polyiso that's 0.35% of the total project cost, but has super high global warming potential? Or we could use this for a tiny percentage more, which is a better product even thermally performing wise, and not have that global warming potential factor. People, planet, profit all the way around.